Hello, adventurers, and welcome. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Ken. I'm going to go over what the vehicle sheet here means up at the top. We've already gone over player character and non-player character, so this one should be nice and quick. I just want to go over a little bit what the different information means and how it applies to you. So if we take a look at our vehicle sheet, let's just make a cart. We have ourselves a nice sheet here. You can notice that it doesn't have any intelligence, wisdom, or charisma. That's because it's not a living entity. It is just a physical structure, sort of object. It's like a vehicle. So you can, usually the PHB or whatever you're using in D&D 5e's PHB, if you're playing one of the Warhammer ones, it's any of the books really that have the vehicle listings in it, or I mean, any game that you're playing usually has a book, and in there it will tell you what these stats are, but you can fill it in and just, I don't know. So usually vehicles aren't super dexterous, but they might have like a hardy constitution. We'll do this, okay? They're immune to poison and psychic because they're not living objects. They're immune to blind, charm, deafened, frightened, paralyzed, petrified, poison, stunned, and unconscious by default. What we have here is, so we have our cart. This is a large object, which you can change here. So we'll say it's huge. Why not? There's a variety of different stats that you can use here. Now I've got D&D Beyond open, so I'll flick over. These are all the kind of stats that would go in, right? So on D&D Beyond, it shows you what the basic information is for your ship or for your vessel. Effectively, what you want to know is just what kind of speed or dimensions or whatever it has. So let's just, for the sake of this, say it's like 15 by 10. PHB, sure. Player's Handbook, why not? Let's say that it has 50 hit points. It's on 50 hit points because it's full HP. Its threshold is... So the threshold is the amount of damage that you need to surpass to, or the amount of attack that you need to surpass to actually damage the vehicle. So let's just say that it's 15. And mishap is, certain vehicles have a mishap rolling rating that you can use, or there's an optional one as well. The AC of the vehicle, let's just say it's 15, sure. This is, so you can put in additional information at the bottom. To roll for a, like if you're rolling for it, like with the health points of like Elise for Reno, for example, we put in a modifier at the bottom. You can just do that here as well. Movement speed. So because it's a vehicle, it's a kind of driving speed, but you would say for a ship, it would be a swim speed. For an airship, it would be a fly speed. The cart itself, let's say that it can move 120 feet around. That's pretty fast. That is actually super fast. Let's go 60. Creature capacity, how many people can fit in or on this actual vehicle? So let's say 6, right? 2 at the front, 4 inside. Cargo capacity, how much weight can the cart actually take? So I don't know, let's just say it's 5,000 or something crazy. Cargo is stuff that you're storing internally as well. So stuff that you're storing on it. So basically just all of it. Action stations and actions, again, this will be outlined for you in the book and what the action thresholds are. So if the cart itself has its own actions that it can take, or if you're, for example, if it's being led by horses and stuff and they are reacting or doing things, they may have their own actions. You can put all of that lumped together. Size of the cart. So like I said, that is just the size. Resistances, immunities, they're usually filled out by default, which is pretty good. Features. So if it has an action, like I said, or any kind of equipment, or if it has a reaction or a weapon, much like with Reno here, he has his own features with his stuff. So you can actually drag that over. And it, now the cart just has a Morningstar. But what you can do is actually put your own custom ones here. For example, maybe there's an action for ramming. So if you're racing carts, maybe you have a one that can ram it to the other. And that's the amount of attack that it would take to like to roll and for the damage and everything. You can always just put that in as a new feature or an action. Equipment would be a similar thing, but you can actually put that in cargo and crew as well if you're just storing equipment rather than actually giving it a weapon or something. So cargo and crew would be more like if we have, if we have, my apologies, like the greatsword, that goes into the cargo. Crew might be, if it's a big airship, what kind of crew members it has, like how, like Tony the pilot, there you go, passengers, Susie passenger, there you go. Not very creative with the names, but there you go. That's how we end up with Boblin the Goblin in all my campaigns. Tony the pilot. So there's, you can put in just the basic information, so you don't need to create a token for all of these people. If you've got an airship full of 50 people, but you just want to have a basic idea who's on it, and you're very detailed or a meticulous note keeper, this is where you put that information. And as I said, you can drag things in here, or you can drag it in here. So you can see the morning stars here, but the shield and the greatsword are here. So you can actually drag the cargo in as a separate entity. You can also place this on, when you place this down, so for the moment it's just this, players can interact with it too if you share it with them, if you give them permissions to. So if they've got permissions to interact with this, they can actually open it and store their own stuff in the cart, which is kind of cool. This was for a long time until there were a lot of modules. This was kind of a very effective way of just having a group bag of holding. Was to just create a vehicle, lump everything out of the vehicle, and they can all see it. So effects, don't worry about that. That's part of a module. I'll explain later. And description is a cart. Same thing as before. Prototype token is effectively exactly the same. Link or don't link for if you've got multiple different ones. If you want everybody to be able to share the information on the sheet, link it. If anyone puts anything on the cart when it's unlinked, it won't be saved when you delete that token. It'll be stored on the token, not on the actual character here. So if I don't have this linked, I drag my cart out and they put all their stuff on it and then you delete it, all their stuff is gone. So make sure that this is linked if you're using it as a vehicle that everyone should be able to interact with. Generally, all vehicles and stuff would be linked, because unless you're putting out like five or six cars that are just chasing each other and doing stuff, you're probably going to link that so that they can take... So if it takes damage and stuff, it updates here. If it's a group vehicle that they use all the time. If you're just throwing a whole bunch out, then don't link them if they're not going to be permanent. If they're just there as more like map assets for fighting or for combat or something, then it's different. If you have them linked and like you have six of them out, they'll all six will take the same damage if one of them is hit. So if you're trying to do something like a big group of them that not necessarily for storage or anything, but just a big group of them in a chase or something, you would unlink it because then they don't all take the same damage. For the cart, so that's the token. So I've shown you that before where you just pick a token and then you do that. You've got your width, your height, and your scale. So 3x3 because it's considered to be huge. If I change huge, technically that should update. So if it changes to large, okay, it's not going to change now, but this would update if I leave and come back in. This will update, so because it's large. So it goes to 2x2. Mirror for the token itself. Position on the map. Vision, does it have vision? Generally a vehicle wouldn't. Unless it's maybe horses. Horses might have vision, of course. And display bars. So displaying, for example, hovered by owner, you might want to have the HP on it so that when you place it down, you can see the health points at the bottom. And that's effectively it. It's very, very simple. A lot of this kind of token creation stuff is very straightforward. You're basically copying information generally from whatever book you're using. If it's like Pathfinder or D&D or Warhammer or whatever, you're just generally, you have a stat book that you're going with and you're putting that information in. If you're at the point where you're homebrewing anyway, you're probably pretty like au fait with this kind of layout, because it's kind of, it's all usually the same structure as whatever game you're playing, right? So this is just your character sheet. It's just spread out over tabs as opposed to being one big sheet. So what you've got here is basically just a breakdown of that. And yes, I did just remind myself that if you want to add a picture, you just click on this and then you can add, I don't know, have a cart or a horse or something. Yeah, sure. And now I've got my horse and cart, why not? And then that's basically it. Then you just drag it out and it has its own health points. People can target it. So if we take Reno here, for example, let's let him attack with the Morningstar. I'm going to give him advantage because he's not great. He still missed. So there you go. But they can attack it. They can target it. They can do the damage if they hit it. And that's effectively it. That's vehicles. That's nice and easy. If you have any questions or anything, let me know in the comments. I'd be more than happy to answer them. And as always, there's closed captioning on all of these videos as well. So if you have any problem understanding me, if I'm going too fast or anything, feel free to check the subtitles too. I'm more than happy to help if you've got questions in the comments. But if you see the comment first and nobody has answered, but maybe you know the answer, feel free to answer it for me. A good community. That's what I'm trying to build here. So good stuff. Thank you so much. Next one, I think we'll be cracking into the beginning of modules, how to install them and what that means. And we'll also then go over some of the basics of creating a map and doing all of that as well. I'll be doing some tutorials to incarnate, for example, to make a world map, and for say Dungeon Alchemist or Dungeon Draft to make world map, to make game maps as well. So we'll go through that in the coming weeks as well. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a wonderful day.